My wife and I have been renovating a 1960s fixer and turning it into an absolutely gorgeous home. Today we'll be tackling the last bathroom in the house, which hasn't been renovated in about 30 years. The project definitely gets wild at times, but it turned out absolutely gorgeous. So welcome to the adventures of my DIY wife and her non-handy husband. Hey everyone, welcome back. It's Dean and Andrea, and today we have the long-awaited bathroom renovation. This video has been a long time in coming, but because it was over a four-week project, the video for it has been absolutely massive to edit, so thank you for being patient, and we are really excited to share this incredible bathroom transformation with you.
If you watched our last bathroom video, you know that we actually did these two bathroom renovations at the same time, and they were huge projects, went a little bit over the timeline that we had thought, and then we were finally getting this video done. And while these projects are so huge, I'm pretty sure these are our favorite transformations that we've put on YouTube this far, and we are so excited to finally share this one with you. As we get started on today's bathroom project, we want to say thank you to today's video sponsor, HelloFresh. With HelloFresh, you get fresh, pre-portioned ingredients and seasonal recipes delivered right to your doorstep. You can go to HelloFresh.com and use code DIYWIFE14 for up to 14 free meals and 3 free gifts. When we're in the middle of a huge project like this bathroom renovation, it is so nice to have some of the meal prep and planning work done for me. HelloFresh provides all of the ingredients I need with exact instructions, and they offer a wide variety of quick and easy recipes, including 20-minute meals, easy cleanup, and low prep options. Not only am I able to save time and stress by not having to meal plan and shop for all of the ingredients, but every recipe we've tried has been absolutely delicious and gotten thumbs up from all 4 of my kids. And HelloFresh isn't just for meals. Their marketplace features a variety of add-ons for breakfast, desserts, and seasonal snacks like Pillsbury pumpkin cookie dough. So if you're interested in trying HelloFresh, go to HelloFresh.com and use code DIYWIFE14 for up to 14 free meals and 3 free gifts. This bathroom is shared by our 2 younger boys, and it is the only room left in our house that hasn't been updated at all yet.
This bathroom currently features the classic shell sinks and brick vinyl flooring, but don't worry, Andrea has plans to transform this old bathroom into something modern and beautiful.
Get ready, first demoing of the bathroom. Dean wants me to say it's demo day.
It's demo day.
We're just gonna kind of gently, you know, like pull it down. We're like, phew! As beautiful as these fluorescent lights were, I'm going to pull them down. We're going to do something a little bit prettier. So far, we've got the fur down. We have an electrician coming soon. We decided to hire that out. We have a lot on our plate, so we'll be adding 2 vanity lights here, just normal lights, no fluorescent lights. Next, we'll start pulling through some of these things on the wall down that we don't want to keep. Remove the countertops, the old tub, the old floor, the old toilet. We're keeping the base of the vanity, which is the new countertops. As much as I love these shell sinks, right here. Oh, I forgot. on a ledge.
Well, that went well.
After we had the vanity wall completely cleared, our electrician was able to come and run wires for the new light fixtures. Next, we removed the trim from the shower faucets so we could work on removing the tub surround.
What happened now? Three. Back for attempt number two here. And we're back for attempt number three here. No. All right, we're back for attempt number four here. See here, I'm using this knife to just score it along the edge there. Loosen it up just a wee bit. Like a pro. Come on! It's really kind of demoralizing, you know? It's just a little faucet. I can't even pull it out of the wall. You know, I'm just gonna chalk it up to that this probably hasn't been moved in about 30 years, and so it's a little tight.
It's a little challenge. Shrink. Just kidding.
I didn't have the right tools, okay? I just didn't have the right tools.
Once we finally had that old trim off of the faucets, we could work on removing this tub surround, and we tried for a long time to pull these out in one piece and not break them so they could be salvaged, but between the amount of glue that was used and then the screws holding the drywall to the studs, it was pretty much impossible.
What is happening? I thought that part was for it to go over your nose.
Okay, is that one good?
That's great. Dude, I'm a DIY Dean, man. Tell you what.
DIY Dean, baby.
DIY dude, man. Trouble with anger, frustration, even rage? Well, come on down to Dean's DIY Anger Therapy, where I'll give you a hammer, a mask, so for all of your anger management needs, come on down to Demo Dean's. Just like that, you'll feel all better, I promise.
Now, I know some of you may be feeling bummed that we just smashed this big jetted tub, but it didn't work, the lines were filled with mold, and I don't honestly think it was humanly possible for us to get this thing out of the house in one piece.
Once the tub was all broken apart, it was time to get it out of the house, and after carrying two or three pieces down the stairs, we decided to work a lot smarter and have a lot more fun by throwing the pieces out the window. Which included a game of try and make it in the wheelbarrow.
Make it in the bucket! No, not even close. Yeah, you're definitely gonna make that one.
I made it. That's a mess. Next, it was time to remove the old countertop, and we forgot to get close-up shots of these, but they were chipped in several places and not something that was salvageable.
And Andrea took this job really seriously, so she wore her aviators to get it done. These shell sinks weighed a ton and I definitely wasn't carrying those down the stairs, so we threw them out of the window.
Shell sink, it was nice knowing you, buddy. Well done, good and faithful shell sink, but your time has come, Bubba.
And just for the record, everything we threw out of the window, I personally cleaned up. And admit it, you enjoyed seeing it get smashed into a million pieces.
Next, we removed the old drywall to make getting the new tub in easier.
And even after taking the drywall out, we still had trouble getting this tub to fit into place, but thankfully our plumber said just leave it and he would take care of it.
Next, it was time to start installing the shiplap. I decided to use vertical shiplap in this space mainly because I really felt like it fit the overall design and vision I was going for, but also because we have vertical shiplap in several other places in the house and this just makes the house feel more cohesive.
All right, so Andrea's been putting in the hard work upstairs in the bathroom and she really could use a coffee. So I'm gonna run to Starbucks and get her a coffee. So how many brownie points did I win? Come on.
The sun is now going down. We're not finished with shiplap. I had ambitious plans of finishing all of this and all of the painting. I'm not gonna get to painting. I'd be happy with finishing the shiplap tonight, which is also maybe unlikely.
How much energy do you have right now?
Not very much. My coffee has thoroughly worn off. I'm tired.
Before Andrea could finish the final section of shiplap, we had to take out this old toilet, which didn't really work right. It wasn't salvageable. And so we gave it the most glorious send-off that a toilet has ever been given.
While I finished installing the shiplap, our tile guy was able to come back and install the Schluter board and the tub surround, and then I filled and sanded all of those nail holes in the shiplap. Even though it's still a total mess in here, it's already looking so much better. Next, I started prepping the vanity for new paint, but I ran into a bit of an unexpected problem.
I wasn't planning on stripping these. I was just gonna prime and paint over because I thought this was attached a lot better. But if I paint over this, then my new paint, even if I prime, it's just gonna peel off with this old finish. You can see they've painted over an oil-based paint right there without the right kind of primer. That's gonna be a lot of work, oh my gosh. But I don't want my cabinets getting all chipped and just looking bad within a few months. So I better do it now. So I'm just gonna use this stuff that I have on hand. It works pretty well, and hopefully this is just like a latex paint. I'm sure it should take it off pretty easily. Normally I would use those little chip brushes to throw away, but I have an old brush that is a little bit damaged and I do not want to make another trip to Lowe's, so I'm gonna use this.
So how tired are you right now?
I'm not tired. What makes you think I'm tired?
What's next?
Got me.
Dad, can I go? Can you tell a story about when you were a kid?
Okay, well one time in eighth grade, I was on the junior high soccer team and I was actually on the team with mommy's brother. And so I would actually see mom at the games. We didn't even talk to each other. We didn't even really know who each other were.
You think we were better soccer players than you?
Probably, yeah.
Hey, Dad, there was... Yes! I can't touch it. Hold on.
After a little coffee pick-me-up, I was able to get the vanity finished and ready for paint, and then started caulking all of the shiplap edges and corners. The next day, I started taping off the bathroom to get ready to paint. But before I could get started painting, I had to get on my paint clothes.
Yeah, you look amazing. So how long have you had these paint clothes?
I don't actually know, maybe 10 years.
Maybe 10 years, but hey, I mean, we're getting our money's worth out of them, right?
I used my favorite shellac-based primer to prime the vanity, the trim, and the doors, and then gave everything a good 2 coats of paint. Between the painting and then the dry time between coats, it took quite a while, but by late that evening, I finally had it all finished.
I'm done painting this bathroom. I primed the ceilings last night. We finally got that vanity where we stripped all the paint off. It's painted, and then I sprayed the ceilings, sprayed all the walls, and I just got the final coat on the walls, and I need a shower. I'm a little bit dirty.
With the painting all finished, our tile guy was able to come the next morning and start installing the tile. I chose this beautiful dark green tile for the shower, and with its matte finish and beautiful handmade texture, it's easily my favorite part of this entire bathroom. We had the tile laid in a horizontal stack for a more modern look, and it gives a nice contrast to the vertical shiplap.
And I just want to say here that these design decisions are something that Andrea labors over again and again until she has everything just right. So it might look like it comes together pretty quickly on film, but this is months in the making for sure.
While the tile was being finished, I took all of the bathroom closet doors outside to paint them. Once the paint was dry, I started reinstalling the doors, and lucky for me, my sister was in town that day, so I had an extra set of hands for help. Once the doors were installed, I added knobs to those along with matching knobs for the vanity. Now, we weren't able to capture me painting the vanity because we couldn't bring a camera in here with all of the paint dust, but I painted it the same matte black color that I used on their built-in bunk beds, and I love the contrast that it provides against the white shiplap.
We're so close to being finished. The tile's finished. He just needs to come back and clean it up and caulk all of the edges. And then I'm getting baseboards in today. And then it's fun stuff. We have countertops coming hopefully later this week. After that, it's just all the finishing touches, like getting the shower curtain up, a rug, all the fun stuff. So close.
Once the countertop and sinks were installed, it was time for the final finishing touches. I went with matte black for all of the fixtures and hardware, and I love the way it looks in this bathroom. One thing I had to add to this bathroom was this elephant clothes hamper because our 4-year-old is absolutely obsessed with elephants. So after months of planning and 4 weeks of hard work, this bathroom was finally finished and it turned out beautiful.
Well, this bathroom turned out incredibly awesome. It was a massive, massive job, and man, this was some kind of adventure.
Yeah, I love this just super dramatic transformation, and like the other bathroom, I have been planning this one for years now, and so it's fun to like get to work through some of those design ideas and finally land on something and then see it come to life. And I feel like it's always so much better in person too. It's like you see it happening before you and you're like, oh my gosh, the tile looks so good, and like, the flooring was perfect, and then the black cabinets and the counters and all of it.
So that's it for this bathroom renovation. We hope you enjoyed going on this adventure with us. And as usual, we'd love for you to stick around and go with us on the next DIY adventure.
Don't mess my hair.
Oh, it smells so good.
Stop. You got boogered in my hair.
We are final.
Okay. You're making me feel out of breath just listening to you. Okay, ready? Okay. No, we've got to keep going.
Pull it together, man. I'm trying. It was the longest line I've ever done. You're floundering. Pull it together. Come up with the line. We got to go. So describe the bathroom to me in one word.
Awesome. Oh. You describe it in one word. That's a wrap. Who wants to come wash my dishes? They stink.
Who wants to wash Andrea's dishes?
Dean does! I never thought I'd convince you to do two bathroom renovations at one time. He does not like renovations.
It's one thing to do a renovation when it's not your job, because it makes me feel like I want to die, because you come home from work and then you renovate and then you have four kids and you're like, oh, this is so awesome. I love renovating. Yes, we can do it. I'm the closer, baby.
You're the closer. Yeah. Oh my gosh.
I wonder if it would look like on camera if I could like fake a punch.
No, I'm scared you're gonna accidentally like push. You hit my nose hairs, babe. I actually hit your nose.
Whoa. We could be action film superstars.
No. Like,
this could be the next Mission Impossible series if you would just work with
Focus.
Me for
just,
a minute.
It's your fault if I hit you. Ready? Yeah.
Dude, how did it look? Are we gonna make it on the big screen?
Actually. Okay, just say your last thing.
I'll be back. That's the only line I could think of.
That's not.
How was that? Did I do pretty good?